How do you know that what you're saying is true?
You're asking me to tell you what is real and what isn't. I know what happened. I know what my father did. And I know what you're trying to do.
Ethan, your disease has altered your memory. Unknowingly to you, of course. But it's there in place to keep you happy.
That's bullshit. You're using what condition I had against me, so no one will find out.
That is not true. We are here. Ethan.
Is my father in there?
Ethan, sit down.
Dad?
We have a situation.
Are you in there? Huh? Did you say me? Did you say your son? You promised me! You promised! You promised!
Experiencing temporary memory loss. We'll be okay.
You know what I need to ask you something? Was this ever about him? Or was it always just about you? Charles, he's your son.
I'm well aware of that.
These are all my things.
Yeah, they are. What else do you remember?
I don't know if I can keep doing this.
Doing what?
Telling you how I feel.
Why?
Honestly, I still feel uncomfortable calling you Dad.
You're gonna be okay. I think we're all gonna be okay. We all just want you to be happy and...
Please.
Hey, you're here now. This is your home. I know it can't be easy starting your life over.
New house, new wife, new kids. You seem to be doing just fine.
I need you to take those twice a day. You just got out of the hospital. Doesn't come without side effects.
What if I forget?
graphic. I remember everything, but I just can't feel it. I know that doesn't make any sense, but I mean, my head hurts sometimes when I think about that stuff. She smiles when she's with you. My sister. She used to be that way all the time. You scared?
No.
You know I'd almost forgotten about it?
Sorry.
You should have dinner with her tomorrow night.
Are you?
I live there. It's your turn to deal with her shit.
Hey, Allie. Who's in the picture? Why do you have to do that?
What?
I hate it when you do this.
This has not exactly been easy.
Will you quit trying to blame me? Or Allie?
I don't. I blame your father.
Jesus. Can we have one dinner without you digging his grave, too?
He did that himself. You have no idea what it is like to love someone for 20 years and then watch them turn and marry the next best thing. It was his responsibility to help us through everything, and he let this family fall apart. Let me tell you something, Ethan. Look at me. Love makes you bleed.
Thank you.
What are you doing?
I thought you were asleep.
What do you possibly think you're gonna find in here, Ethan, huh?
What happened to me?
You saved your life, Ethan.
I know you keep saying that, but I really think I'm okay. I just need to know.
Well, there's some things I can't tell you. Understandings of a doctor-patient relationship.
What about a father-son relationship?
I can't. Sorry. Don't come in here ever again.
It's not like I don't remember stuff. Like when I gave you that. If you know something, I wish you'd tell me.
I wish you didn't believe I had something to hide.
Okay.
Have you talked to Luke?
No.
I miss him.
I think I'm gonna go.
Ethan. Our family. You're the only one who still wants it. Let's not let that get between us. Me.
I think you're giving yourself too much credit.
No, I'm not.
Okay. Forget it.
Sit down, Ethan. I was just kidding.
How'd you know my name?
Everyone knows your name. Hey, Ethan, what a pleasant surprise.
Hey, Miss Linda. You got a minute? Do you know Camille?
I don't know, maybe. Do you remember this?
Who's that? I don't remember that.
Ethan. That is your brother. Adam.
What are you doing here?
Your stepmom let me in.
She did?
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me.
Oh, sorry. Please. It's a little cleaner than I remembered.
You've never been in my room before. Have you?
It's a little cleaner than I would have thought.
What are you doing here?
Okay. I came to say I'm sorry about yesterday. I'm sorry.
Okay.
You paint?
No.
You did cheese.
You ask a lot of questions.
They're really beautiful, Ethan.
I mess around sometimes.
How come they don't have faces?
I can't do faces.
Have you ever read the poem Belusta? I'm in the adapted play tomorrow night. You should come. I believe you know where it is.
Right. You know, you're supposed to stand 8 feet away.
There's a goddess in the poem, also faceless, who I play. My first show and you can't even see my face. Anyway, it's supposed to represent the unknowable future. And it's 6 feet not eight.
No, it's eight.
It's six.
No, it's eight.
You should come. Say something.
Mom.
What?
Mom, you need help.
No, I'm okay.
Mom, please.
Ethan, give me some time. I'll be all right, I promise.
Don't promise. You don't mean it, don't promise.
What makes you think I'm not going to keep it?
Do you have any pictures of Adam?
What for?
Yes or no, please.
No, I don't.
Mom, don't lie to me.
I don't have any!
You need to help, Mom.
Why? She hates me.
Because she needs help.
Don't we all?
Dad, this is serious.
I am serious. All she wants from me is money, so don't stand there and tell me about how much she needs help. It's a waste of time.
You were married to her for 20 years.
And now we're divorced.
And it's about to happen again.
Unbelievable. Look around. You like this little paradise world you live in, huh? Don't get too attached to it. Maybe I'll be gone very soon.
What the hell does that even mean?
What does that mean? Well, it means that my good friend, my former employee, rather, Milo Softly, has filed a lawsuit against us. Yeah. I think he met him when we left the hospital.
Dad.
What?
Can I live with you from now on?
What's wrong with your mother?
Will you help her or not?
You gonna take that thing out of your lip?
I'll get my things tomorrow.
In this room?
I have no idea.
Yes, you do.
Ethan, what's wrong with you?
Do you keep secrets, Allie?
We all keep our secrets, Ethan.
Yeah.
Ethan, what's wrong?
Why was I in the hospital? I'm serious.
I have no idea what you're talking about. I promise. I would tell you.
I think the answer's in there.
It's a storage room, Ethan.
There are secrets. There are secrets in there.
Have you been taking your medicine?
No.
I think you should. Dad said he'd help her.
That's good. Interesting.
Yes, it is. What are you doing now?
I don't know. I hadn't really thought about it. Why?
Are you sure you want to know? Okay, I'll tell you. We're having a party. I took the key from the hotel I work at.
Isn't that illegal?
Well, he's fine. They won't even know we're there.
Ethan, come on. We're leaving.
You should go.
Come on. It'll be fun. Ethan, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I've discovered something about you, Ethan. You're a compulsive liar. You should smile more often. What? What's so funny?
You're not the first person who's told me that.
Well, if I may plead my case, Mr. Eason, a life is not worth living if you don't have something to smile about.
Well, you might not be yourself then.
Well, actually, I'm a figment of your imagination.
Really? That's interesting. I would think if I made you up, then you'd be taller. I have a short skirt.
it's not. There's something wrong with me.
Why do you think that is?
You stopped taking your pills.
Look at me.
What?
These are important.
I forgot.
Well, you can forget a lot of things, Ethan.
Don't forget these. Since when have you really cared?
Well, Ethan, stop. You're still my son.
It's not about these fucking pills. You know something. And you've gone to extensive lengths to make sure that I don't find out about it. I can't take it anymore. You told everyone I know never to speak about Adam? I know this has something to do with the fact that I was in the hospital. But you're the only one that can tell me about that. Aren't you?
The day your brother killed himself, something happened to you as well.
Something? You're a fucking neurosurgeon. Something doesn't cut it.
If you want me to tell you, I would suggest you lower your voice. Sit down. When you saw him, when you saw Adam, an artery ruptured in your brain. Lack of oxygen damaged some areas that are necessary for you to properly recall your memories. You blocked out your brother and everything having to do with it. So in essence, you forgot. I need you to know that I was trying to help you, Ethan. I thought it was best if those things stayed forgotten. and I try to keep it that way. Ethan. You blamed yourself for what happened.
Do you know what predetermination is?
Like fate? What do you mean?
There's a difference. If you believe in fate, then all the choices you make, both right and wrong, are not yours. You think that they are, but they happen that way because they have to.
Well, what do you believe?
I'd like to believe I'm in control of my own life. Although lately it doesn't feel that way. There are things in place. But it's my decision. To be here. That's predetermination.
Ethan, look at me. I don't know why you worry about these things you can't control. Like your past, your family, your friends. Thank you. I like it.
Allison.
Just leave me alone.
You need help? Promise me.
Okay. I promise. I promise, baby.
Thank you.
body hurts. What are you doing here?
Can you take a look at something for us? I was hoping you might be able to tell me where you got it.
How do you know my name?
Everyone knows your name.
Who are you?
My name is Dr. Milo Softly. I used to work for your father.
Filing a lawsuit against him?
I'm assuming he hasn't told you why.
No.
What would you say if I told you I knew what was happening to you? People cope with traumatic events differently. Some worse than others.
What happened to her?
This isn't about her, Ethan. This is about you. How much do you know?
I know this is where my dad works.
We're nowhere near your father right now, Ethan. Or anyone else. We're in a room. In my house.
What's happening to me? Why am I saying what I'm saying?
You are something, Ethan. You really are. And I think it's very admirable of you, trying to find yourself in such a way. Ethan, you're asking the wrong questions. You saw the x-rays. What do you think that was? It's a microcomputer, a silicone hippocampus chip. We all have memories which we would prefer to forget. Your father never told you what he was doing because he wasn't sure that it would work. To be honest, Ethan, you were in no condition to argue with him. The next thing you knew, you awoke in a hospital, unaware of any of this. Ethan, ever since your surgery, you've been combining your past and your present to create your own happiness. Your condition, even, causes you to think your dreams are real life.
It stopped working. Because I remembered my brother.
No, Ethan. You don't have a brother. It was you. As an artificial part of your brain. Because it was damaged, everything that you now remember is directly connected to the hippocampus chip. You are dependent on it for normal functioning.
I don't know what to believe. Why are you helping me?
Ethan! What? What do you want from me? We have a case. You can't fight back.
Ethan, I'm really not in the mood right now. Can we just...
I don't care. I have something to say, and you're gonna listen.
I'll let go of my hand.
Why?
Let go of my hand.
Why should I listen to anything you have to say? I haven't been in control of my life in a long time, and I have you to thank for that.
This is ridiculous. It's late. Get out of my room.
I want to let you know it's not working. It stopped working.
Ethan, I don't think you understand.
I had a talk with Milo softly this afternoon. You know him? Don't you?
What did he tell you?
I know what you did. I know everything.
I gave you a chance to
stop. No. What you gave me was a life that wasn't my own. I don't want that. You insulted me. I want you to take it out.
Well, I don't think you
really... If there's one thing I will ever ask of you, this is it. I'm not broken. You cannot fix whatever it is you think is wrong with me. I am who I am.
Ethan, this chip is a major part of your cognitive functioning. If I remove it, it'll be as if we never had this conversation. You will not remember any of this.
You don't know that.
Yes, I do. It is your hippocampus. It tells your memories where to go and how they will be remembered. Without it, Ethan, please, 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 for the love of God, do not make this decision despite me.
Well, I've been there before, haven't I? If I don't remember any of this, then that's my decision.
Ethan, please, please, please.
If you won't do it, I'll call Milo.
Okay. I'll do it.
Truthfully, you've been upset for so long, I can't remember a time when we were happy. But that's why we're here. I felt angry when you drank. But I still love you. I felt hurt and lonely. You tried to hurt. And try to hurt yourself. But I still love you. I felt upset. I felt ashamed. When Allie told me how she found you. I still love you. And I hate it when you lie. I still love you.
Good to see you, man. It's good to be home.
I'm glad you're back.
Yeah, me too.
Thanks.
Let's go back inside, alright? You coming?
I think I'm gonna stay out here for a little while.
Thank you.
Truth is, in fact, the most important piece of information in any event with such discrepancies as the ones we've been faced with here. The brain is the most powerful and fragile part of the human body. But in this case, it's the object in question. Mr. Ethan Galloway will further undergo a series of BCI tests, which record the exact radioactivity that his brain emits. These tests do not confabulate, and they will be done before and after the removal of the hippocampus chip. It is the son of Charles Galloway whose wishes will be granted, no matter how serious the consequences. To be sure that this is really what you want before you take this path. After this, there's no turning back.